Also.
Right, where do we start with a song called Give That Wolf a Banana?
Den siste tida før den låta her ble til, så hadde jeg på en måte endelig begynt å få til det der å bli låtskriver og få til en del låter for andre artister. Noe som hadde fått ganske sånn mersmak på, så derfor så dro jeg for aller første gang I mitt liv til en låtskrivercamp.
So we went up to Rena for a MGP songwriting camp. And we usually get like an artist in the room with us so that you can focus on, you know, how could this artist be presented at MGP.
Fikk utdelt et rom, bare jeg, Carl-Henrik og Ben. Og min overraskelse da var at vi ikke fikk en artist.
I guess we were a bit bummed out that we didn't have like an artist in the room, because we were a bit, I guess, directionless.
Så du kan trygt si at vi endte opp med en låt vi ikke vanligvis skriver.
See where you're going, but I don't know where you've been. Hmm? Is that saliva or blood?
What's saliva?
It's like spit. Is that saliva or blood dripping off your chin?
I think we were just having a laugh that day. We were just, you know, anything that was coming through, we were just joking about it. Keith was written just because it rhymed with teeth.
Not sure you have a name, so I will call you Keith.
Perfect.
If you don't like the name Keith, I'm gonna call you Jim.
Oh! That's brilliant.
Can we do that?
That's brilliant. Yeah, that's...
For min del så, så jeg et klipp fra det der israelske som sang seg back, 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 greier. Så tenkte jeg, ok, kylling, hva med dyr? Så tenkte jeg, ulv. Så jeg hadde en sånn god idé om at vi skulle lage en låt basert på rødhet og ulven.
She's gonna visit her grandmother, but she meet the wolves.
Så var kjære Brumunddal begynte å nevne ulver da. Men så sitter han samtidig og spiser en banan. Og så kommer da Ben og sier, ja, what if you gave that wolf a banana?
Jeg trodde jeg hadde fått den på gli helt til Ben sier, give that wolf a banana.
Ok.
Put it in. Here we go.
Banana. Banana.
Og så sitter han og han bare himler med øya.
Altså, jeg skjønner ikke hva han mener, liksom. Give that wolf. Det gir liksom ingen mening, men han står på sitt give that wolf a banana, og jeg bare, ok, jeg gir opp han fyren her. Det fucker opp alt det jeg har planlagt her nå, men...
Give that wolf a banana, give that wolf a banana, give that wolf a banana, make him go woo! Give that wolf a banana...
Så setter jeg meg ned og tenker, så... Ok, jeg er fortsatt på rødhet og ulven, så jeg... tenker da, ok, banana, grandma, gir det til Ben, ok, lag noe med banana, grandma. Og så skriver han, before that wolf eats my grandma, give that wolf a banana.
Someone give that wolf a banana!
Og så, yes, der har vi den.
I want your grandma, yum, yum!
Yes. Etter at låta var ferdig, så var det jo lyttesession. Da viste alle de som var på campen låtene til hverandre.
In the listening room, people were kind of... really vibing it and then singing it afterwards and stuff like that and we're like oh okay maybe it's not so stupid.
Alle digga det.
It was kind of a nice surprise that people started liking it really.
Den dagen så kom det jo da en låt som heter Give That Wolf a Banana. Jeg må si at jeg lo litt både når jeg hørte låta og hørte teksten. Men umiddelbart så var det liksom, den var så jævla catchy, og det var et eller annet ved den låta som jeg bare ikke, jeg kunne ikke stoppe å tenke på den låta.
I certainly didn't think anything more of it until NRK got in touch and said, yeah, we really like this song. And my reaction was like, you do? What?
And before that wolf eats my grandma, give that wolf a banana, give that wolf.
Da innså vi ganske fort at, ok, her kan det være noe.
And then they were like, well, you know, who's gonna sing it? And we're like, we don't know. Do you got any ideas? Like, nope. So then we had a mission to try and find the artist who would do this incredible tune.
Hello? Yeah, hello. Det Gaute.
Jeg husker meg Idol finale 2003. Det er lenge siden. He said he was a little busy now.
Men det viste seg at det blir litt vanskelig å finne.
Yeah, and we think maybe you'd you'd be the man for the job. Why not? No, okay. He said he doesn't like bananas.
Surprisingly, it's quite hard to find any artist that's willing to put their career on the line with a song called Give That Wolf a Banana. We couldn't find anybody that wanted to do it.
Yum, 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 yum. Meow, 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 meow. Jeg synes det kulere hvis det katter.
Ja, det skjønner jeg. Nei, men vi sender den uansett, så får du se. Okay.
So then we went to NRK and we were like, okay, well, we know you like the song, but we just can't find anybody to do it. And to which their response was, well, why don't you do it? And we were like, no, absolutely not.
So why can't you just sing it then? You can dance. This song
Me?
Needs someone that can dance and sing.
I'm not going to do it.
What?
I already did MGP before with A1. I don't think it's not right. Well, why don't you do it?
I'm from Brummedalen. I sing in Hedmarksdialekt.
Ja, det var jo blandet følelser, for jeg ville jo absolutt ha med låta, men jeg hadde overhovedet ikke lyst til å være med i MGP og synge selv, og jeg kunne jo ikke ødelegge mitt gode navn og rykte, så da, det var jo da tanken om kostymer og maske kom inn.
We don't have to reveal it ever.
Never reveal it.
Yeah. It's not like take off the mask like in Maskorama.
Det går ikke an å være et menneske og fremføre denne sangen.
Okay, now we have this amazing song, and how are you going to perform it? Is it going to be you guys?
Yeah, but I think we just need masks.
Det er klart, jeg tenkte jo først at alle i Norge kjenner jo igjen stemmen min, så det kommer jo ikke til å funke med meg med maske. Men samtidig så slo det meg at de som 20 år i dag, de var jo ikke født når jeg var på Idol og så videre. Så derfor fant jeg ut at det kanskje det faktisk mulig å gjøre det. Jeg jo ganske mange som har glemt meg.
I'm really glad that you understand Dan, that our song is brilliant, but I don't trust that Ola Nordmann will understand that this song is brilliant, and that's why if we are supposed to do it, we need masks. And
you know, they started asking us questions about, so why the masks? What kind of masks are we going to have?
It can be anything.
As long as we're not guilt, and then I think it's...
Yeah.
I mean, we had to come up with like a backstory. What about this? We're wolves from space.
So Neil Armstrong comes along, and he says, he tells us this story about the Red Riding Hood eating the grandma, and he says that the best way to solve that is to give the wolf bananas.
And NRK went, yeah, sounds good. Does it? Yeah, okay, cool. That's what we're doing then.
I starten av MGP så var det jo veldig absurd egentlig å skulle være anonym, fordi jeg har jo vært såpass lenge i bransjen at jeg kjenner jo nesten alle. Så når jeg gikk rundt som Jim, så kjente jeg jo folk rundt meg, men jeg kunne jo ikke snakke med dem. Så det var jo veldig rart.
Oi, 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 her kommer det noen galaktiske superstjerner innom.
Personlig så ville jeg ha en tant som var veldig bra, men samtidig litt sånn teit. Problemet er at jeg kan ikke danse. Jeg er helt elendig. Så jeg øvde og øvde for å få inn denne dansen. Så slo det oss at søren, ikke bare skal vi danse, vi skal stå under maske og synge live på nasjonal TV mens jeg danser.
I don't think we'd actually even thought about it, that you know, maybe it might be quite hard. It's my verse at the beginning. I haven't even started choreography then. So, you know, by the end of the song, I'm like, So I called Gauter and I was like, dude, have you tried to do both at the same time? This is not going to go very well for us.
Så da Ben kom opp med den geniale ideen.
You have to be in the DJ outfit, and then you can stand still and do nothing behind the DJ thing while you're singing, and then bop around for the rest of it. I don't even think we asked NRK, because the rules are you have to be on stage singing. It didn't say who on stage had to be singing.
Han som da skulle være DJ-astronaut, han fikk jo ikke vært DJ-astronaut på scenen, fordi da gikk Gaute inn i hans kostyme isteden.
And that kind of worked out a bit better. So then Gauter had to be going in between two outfits. Whenever we were performing, he was the DJ. And then whenever we were doing promo or interviews or anything like that, he'd have to, you know, get straight back into the wolf outfit and then sort of play two parts. Maybe he should get double the money. Don't tell him.
Give that wolf a banana. Når man har en NGP-låt, så jo målet å vinne. Men vi var jo allikevel litt usikre på om Norge var klare for dette her.
Det som har vært veldig rart med hele MGP-opplevelsen at for en gang skyld så går liksom alt etter planen. Vi lagde en plan, og det funket. Det var liksom, det gikk etter planen. Det skjer jo aldri. Hva er det? Jagger søren meg klart for faktisk å vinne hele greia. Nei, det helt sjukt.
175.615.
PA'en jo ut i salen. Vi hadde ikke noen monitorer foran oss, så vi hørte jo ikke tydelig hva som ble sagt i det hele tatt. Og jeg sto jo inne i den der astronauthjelmen i tillegg, og jeg har dårlig hørsel fra før, så jeg hadde ikke sjans til å høre hvem som ble utkåret til vinner.
I think you can see it on the TV show. We basically just stand there static, and I'm there sort of safe to gather through the side of my mouth, like, did we win? And he went, I think so, but just hold still for a second, because I don't know.
Det tok sikkert et halvt minutt før jeg skjønte at vi hadde vunnet. Men jeg skjønte etter hvert, og da var jeg, når jeg endelig skjønte det, så ble jeg jo sjuk for da.
Gauter was in the DJ outfit at that point, and I think he thought he was hugging me at the end, so he's got this really long hug with our dancer. To celebrate, of course the dancer was a big part of it as well, but like, I was sort of on the side going like, oh, I'll celebrate on my own, well. But it was really great.
Subwoofer!
I kveld ble det avgjort at den maskerte duoen Subwoofer får æren av å representere Norge I Eurovision Song Contest I mai.
Okay, so, one MGP going to Eurovision.
Eurovision Song Contest, the biggest music show on the planet.
Når du skal representere Norge I Eurovision, så det svært. Liksom. Det stort for norske medier, det stort for internasjonale medier. Sånn at det at man ikke hadde avslørt identiteten til artistene, gjorde at mediene var jo overalt.
Ja, for oss så var det jo dødsviktig, særlig I starten, å virkelig holde oss hemmelig. Vi ville være hemmelig, vi ville ikke at noen skulle vite hvem vi var. Ja, det var jo en VG-reporter som da valgte å ta bilde av bilskiltene våre. Der gikk vi jo på en smell.
The reporter had gone round and photographed every car in the parking lot to see if one of them was ours. Now, my number plate is fairly recognizable. I didn't really think this one through.
Vi avtalte jo veldig tidlig at vi bare skulle nekte uansett, så...
Ja. I think the game was kind of up then, but we still played along with it.
Guys, you won Melody Grand Prix. How does it feel?
I don't know. I haven't really...
You're happy, right?
Yeah. But like now we have to like be Subwoofer for months.
The masks were so amazing, perfectly good idea if we were going to lose this thing. But now we have to go to Italy in masks. Or how are we supposed to do this?
So then obviously we have to think about the logistics of traveling to Eurovision and being part of that whole circus with nobody knowing who we are. They gave us these outfits that basically made us look like Robocop.
Norske medier ringte jo hotellet vårt og spurte om å få bekreftet om det bodde noen der som het Gaute eller Ben. De var skrevet inn som Keto Dream Wolf. Og det var det jo ingen som spurte om, så det gikk for så bra.
It was tricky. It was difficult. And even going in and out of the arena and talking to the other artists, well, we weren't allowed to talk to the other artists, so we were very much just stuck to our dressing room, really, and then just in hiding the whole time.
Så klart for min del som vant til å spille I Løten og Odalen og Ålesund og sånne steder, så var det jo kult å komme til Torino og du merket jo liksom at det var et stort opplegg.
You know, we were representing Norway and it was Eurovision and you know, quite a big deal that we were doing that. It was, you know, it wasn't just like treated as like a joke, it was very deadly serious. So one of our biggest challenges was...
Vi kunne jo ikke snakke for alle, ville kanskje kjente en stemme noe deres.
How do you promote a song to everyone in Europe without speaking or anybody knowing who you are or any facial expressions or anything. Like, how do you do it? And we're like, we don't know, so maybe we need a translator. Oh, okay, let's try and find a translator. Who can we get? I know who can do it. Carl can do it. That's the perfect translator. So he was like, oh, I don't know if my English is good enough. Like, that's even funnier.
Are you saying world or war? That's a big difference. To the war, we say make wolf, not war.
Jeg trives veldig godt I studio. Jeg trives veldig godt foran pulten og bak glasset. Og plutselig ble puttet I søkelyset på den måten der. Det var uvant for en enkel sjel fra Rena.
He's there doing all the interviews for us. He doesn't actually know what we want to answer. And then because we're doing hundreds of interviews, we start messing about with him a bit.
Jeg får et seriøst spørsmål, og så bare begynner jeg å gestikulere med et eller annet. Ja, bare sånn. Ja. Og så bare prøver jeg å skjønne hva dette her da. Og det jo, altså, hva det her?
So we're like answering completely different questions, doing really random things, and just I'm laughing inside the costume, trying to see what he's going to come up with as a sensible answer.
Do you have a final message ahead of the jury final for all of your fans? Oh, please don't joke.
Wolf for Norway.
We've only got one song, so how do we show people that we're a band? Okay, we'll have to do some more songs. So we would just sit in the hotel room during the Eurovision period and make up spoofs of other songs. So we, you know, oh, let's do Justin Bieber, the baby, and we'll make up our own subwoofer lyrics. And then, hey, let's just shoot a video for it while we're in the hotel. Put it together in a few hours, out it went. And those things were getting like millions of views. So, you know, we could see that there was like a train of, it was like trial and error, and everything we were trying and the weirder we were being, the more successful it was being. So we're like, oh, okay, that worked, let's just do more. And I think that's been the story of Subwoolfer the whole way along.
Stig Carlsen, kan du bekrefte at det var tikset vi så under astronautmasken?
Vi lever godt med den mystikken som her, så jeg vet jo ikke helt hva du har sett, men...
We can fly ticks to Turin, last year's winner.
Yeah, that would be fun.
Astronaut.
That's a great idea. Would he be up for it?
Subwoolfer gjorde jobben, klare for Eurovision-finale.
Yeah, so then it's the day of the final, and we don't know how it's going to go down at all. We're pretty sure that the juries are going to just kill the whole thing because, you know, they want to hear serious ballads and blah, 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 blah. And here we are with a sort of, I don't want to say a joke song because actually it's not a joke song. It was actually, I think it's perfect for Eurovision. If there's no other stage that you could do this song on.
Og da vi klare. Lykke til, Norge og Subwoofer!
Når du synger live for 220 millioner, så jo hver eneste tone den viktigste tone du har gjort I hele ditt liv. Så du vet liksom at don't fuck it up, don't fuck it up, hver eneste tone. Så tenker jeg bare, ok, syng riktig. Følte vel at det gikk ganske bra, så når ferdig, så var det sinnssykt deilig å ta en øl.
That was crazy. And I liked the dance as well.
The song is so good. It's so catchy.
I thought that was great.
And that's what you want a Eurovision entry to be.
I can see this doing really well for Norway when it comes to... 183 points.
So we have a winner! So then we came top 10, and I think that's a pretty amazing result. Particularly thinking about where we started. It was very strange because it was sort of like, okay, that could have been the end of whatever this project was. But then we started seeing just how popular the song had become.
This is a quality song. You could hear it on the mainstream radio.
It's like a pulsating, pumping bass line, which is nice. It's good for the nightclub.
Once you hear it, it will never get out of your mind. It's Give That Wolf a Banana. It's very catchy. Our kids love it, and it became part of the breakfast ritual.
I think this song is gonna explode on TikTok.
Vi hadde jo jobbet en del med å lage videoer og sånt på TikTok, men vi hadde vel kanskje 10.000 følgere, og så vi det bare gikk 11.000, 12.000, 13.000. For hvert minutt vi sjekket, så var det liksom, hadde det gått opp 1.000 følgere da. Og det stoppet jo ikke før, var det 550.000 eller noe, så det var ganske crazy.
You know, of course, Norway had known about us for several months, and this was our first introduction. It's the first time people had seen us all over Europe, so then people were just discovering it all over again.
Ja, plutselig satt vi jo der liksom med ekstremt mange fans, rett og slett, som plutselig trodde vi var et band, så da hadde vi ikke noe valg. Vi måtte jo bare lage flere sanger, rett og slett.
I would say that was the beginning of Subwoolfer, rather than what could have maybe have been the end of a strange project. Then it was just like an onslaught of, you know, gig offers and just like how do we take this project and run with it. Okay, well, let's just see how much fun we can have with this project. I don't think any of us have been part of a project that is quite as, I guess, free. You know, we can literally do whatever we want, whatever kind of song we want. We can be funny, we can just be ridiculous, or we can be serious. The most challenging thing for all of us was that this came along as a bit of a surprise. So I basically had my entire year planned out. That's where the fun started happening.
Det som så genialt med konseptet jo selvfølgelig at vi kan av og til putte andre under maska.
We were like, okay, well, we're booked on this big gig and one of us can't make it. Do we just not do the gig? Or...
Hvis det en dag du ikke kan, så kan du putte en annen. Kan en annen være Jim. Det går fint.
You know, whenever it's really big deals or stuff that we can make, we're all there in the costumes doing it. But sometimes there have been occasions where it's just not possible. For example, we were booked on one of the biggest TV shows at Christmas, the big fat quiz of the year.
You all want to know what the lyrics are?
No.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's find out. All the way from Norway, it's Subwoolfer. Oh.
And Gauter couldn't make it because he was on a Christmas tour. So it was like, well, we either don't do it or we have to find somebody. Now, nobody was available at Christmas to do it. So I said to my wife, I said, ah, you know, you said you really wanted to go to England to, you know, see our family over Christmas and we couldn't find time. She went, yeah. I was like, well, what if I said to you, we can go and all the expenses are paid, hotels booked, flights. She was like, that's amazing. How? Why? I was like, well, all you have to do is jump into a wolf outfit. And there was like silence on the phone. And then after a while she went, yeah, okay, let's do it. So, and she actually knew, she knew the routine probably better than Gauter did, to be fair. So actually when you see the big fat quiz of the year, that is me and my wife. As Jim and Keith.
Har dere noen planer om å ta av dere masker noen gang?
Vi føler jo for så vidt etter hvert at det er jo snart den dårligste hemmeligheten i verden etter julenissen, hvem som er under maska.
Noen mener at det er Ben Adams som skjuler.
Om at det er Gaute Ormåsen som skjuler seg bak den ene subwooferen.
Ja, så det har jo vært i tillegg veldig vanskelig å promotere låter, da, for vi kan jo ikke snakke og så videre.
We decided to unmask at the MGP final, which seemed like the most fitting place to do it. People, I think by now, kind of know who we are anyway, but why not, you know, go out with a bang? Oh! I think the idea for unmasking is to be able to still do what we're doing, because it's a lot of fun and people still love it.
Yeah. So awesome.
It has been a wild ride keeping up with these two. What a way to do it. A year later on the same stage. Oh my God, I just cannot stop smiling. What a ride.
Det er ikke så viktig lenger om folk vet eller ikke vet, fordi Subwoolfer fortsatt et band. Subwoolfer Jim, Keith og DJ Astronaut. Vi bare en del av teamet rundt Subwoolfer, på en måte. Og vi henter en hjelp utenfra og tar imot all hjelp egentlig, til å bare utvikle Subwoolfer videre, for å bli så stort som mulig.
So we've got loads of gigs booked up, loads of music still yet to come, and that's how it kind of is, you know, at home and everywhere else and on the way to gigs and outside and, you know, TV shows and stuff, we are Ben and Gauta going to perform as Subwoolfer.
Det gir en masse nye muligheter for oss til å ta Subwoolfer inn I en helt ny fase.
We just move into Subwoolfer part two.
Yeah.